Well, Kenan, thank you for taking a few minutes of your time to chat with us here. And you're getting ready to host the NHL Awards. And not only are you doing it again, as you did in 2019, but you're doing it from right here in Tampa, which I know you call home at least part of the time. So how much are you looking forward to that?
I'm super duper looking forward to it. You know, Tampa's been, you know, a second home, you know, like as far as like second places I've lived type things. You know, I went from Atlanta to LA and New York or whatever, but you know, as far as like owning a house is concerned, like Tampa's kind of the, you know, first place I've done that. So it's definitely been, you know, home for several years now. We're almost going on a decade soon. So we're really excited to come back down there and like, you know, do some big production type stuff in the hometown. That'll be fun.
Absolutely. Was there anything in particular that drew you to the area, or what made you first decide to come down here?
Yeah. My wife went to like middle school and high school there, and my mother-in-law still lives down there. So it's nice to have, you know, grandma right down the street, stuff like that.
Oh yeah. Definitely a big help with the kids, I'm sure. Yeah. So as I mentioned, this, you did host back in 2019. And since we are, you know, Tampa Bay Lightning fans down here, you definitely included a fair share of jokes about the whole getting swept by Columbus last time. So have you been able to rebuild your relationship with those guys in the last couple of years here?
Yeah, I hope so. I mean, me and Alex Killorn are still tight in my mind, you know, so I'm looking forward to maybe another doc talk once they win this next one, you know. So fingers crossed, man, you know, we're rooting for them. It was a tough, you know, tug of war when they were playing the Rangers and everything, just because I have a lot of love for the Garden too, you know, and I've been going there for years and years, and they're just, you know, two good cities, and it was a great series, you know, but I'm really proud of the Lightning, man. You know, they must have took my jokes to heart.
Right. It was the motivation from the jokes that, you know, I'm into back-to-back champs, and now maybe a three-peat here.
I'll take that credit.
And hosting the awards, what is that like for you?
It's so much fun. You know, it's a chance for me to actually get up and close with a lot of different players that I would probably never get a chance to meet because they play in all these different cities and stuff like that. And it's just nice to celebrate the world of hockey and everybody that kind of helps that community grow on so many different levels, from, you know, intramurals all the way up to the pros and stuff like that. And it's just nice to see the players in a relaxed environment with their families and stuff like that. And it's fun for me because I get to, you know, toss around some jokes and just, you know, have a good time.
And because you have been on SNL for so long now, I imagine there's some similarities when it comes to hosting and being on the show, but how would you kind of compare the two experiences?
They're similar because, you know, especially when we do like pre-tapes, we did a couple of, you know, characters and stuff like that, hopefully that will play in the show and people will be able to laugh at. So that experience is very similar because I'm waiting to see the response, basically. So anytime we do a pre-tape at SNL and we all watch it while the audience is watching it, you know, it's like fingernail biting time, you know, like, because you want them to laugh at it. So watching the reactions in real time when you're not performing, it's very nerve-wracking a little bit. But, you know, this is hockey, so we just have a good time. And as long as everybody's pretty much humble, you know, it's a very humble kind of, you know, sport community. Everybody's, you know, pretty family oriented, you know, boots on the ground type stuff. So as long as that attitude is in the air, you know, we just have a good time.
Absolutely. That's awesome. Okay. So I got a little bit of a quick little game for you here, because there are 5 awards being announced during the NHL Awards on Tuesday. And even to, you know, some of the fans who follow hockey the closest, you know, the names of them don't necessarily, you know, tell exactly what they're all about. Right. So I'm going to leave it to you. If you were to rename these awards to better describe them, mm-hmm. What would you name them? So the first one, I'll throw at you, is the Hart Trophy for the MVP.
What would I rename the Hart Trophy for the MVP? Let's see. Slick Daddy, the Slick Daddy Trophy.
Yeah. I like that. That's catchy. It has a nice ring to it. Perfect. All right, next one, the Vezina Trophy for top goaltender.
Oh, Sticky Fingers. Yeah. Sticky Fingers is good. A good one.
Good. There's a reason that you're good at your job. Okay. Norris Trophy, top defenseman.
Oh, yeah. We'll call that one the Beast.
All right. Victor Hedman's up for it this year. Do you think he's got a shot?
Oh, he's a beast. Absolutely. Come on, Vic. That's what's up. Good old Tampa boy. I love it.
Awesome. All right. A couple more. Calder Trophy for Rookie of the Year.
Calder. We'll call that one Youngblood.
I like that. Okay. And then last one, Ted Lindsay Award for the most outstanding player as voted on by the National Hockey League Players Association.
Let's see. I wanted to call it like this year's GOAT, but let's just call it, we'll call it the Cisco for like the platinum hair. It's like, you know, the platinum edition of a player. Call it the Cisco.
I think those are fantastic. I mean, I'm sure you have connections with the league. I think maybe we need to start implementing some of these, yeah?
Oh, yeah, I'm going to start talking to some folks.
Obviously, you've joked about inclusion and representation in hockey in the past, but then you've also kind of taken some action yourself on it, including that op-ed on Willie O'Ree you wrote last year. So I just wondered, you know, why specifically within the sport of hockey is it really important to you?
I mean, it's, you know, important across, you know, just the gambit of life, basically. But, you know, since we are on the subject of hockey, yeah, it feels like there could be, you know, just more awareness maybe even in other cultures that hockey is a great sport. You know, it's a great sport to get involved with. It's a great community. And just trying to, like, raise awareness, you know, I guess, to that option. You know what I mean? It's a very inclusive community, in my opinion, as far as the people that I know that have grown up in it. They all seem to have grown up with a very, you know, family kind of, you know, support system. Like, the whole community gets behind them. Like, the NHL is doing a lot for people that can't necessarily afford the equipment and stuff like that. So it seems like there's a lot of initiatives happening in the, you know, direction of trying to get people into hockey that, you know, wouldn't necessarily normally migrate that way or whatever. And I just think that's really cool. And I think jokes help open up that conversation. You know what I mean? It's just a, you know, a humorous observation, if you will, but at the same time, it does take action. And I think the NHL is doing a solid job of that.
Right. And then you talked about raising awareness. I mean, are you kind of sick of the knuckle puck references when it comes to the Mighty Ducks and stuff like that? Or is it kind of a badge of honor? Like, wow, this, it did have, you know, an impact. Maybe a lot of people.
Yeah, it's a huge badge of honor. You know, like, I think almost everybody that plays hockey is, you know, watch the Mighty Ducks. Like, I get so much love from it, you know, almost 30 years down the road. You know what I mean? Like, I'm still able to go to hockey games because of it and stuff like that. And it's just like almost like a key to the hockey city, basically. And yeah, you know, my part was the knuckle puck. So yeah, it's a badge of honor for sure.
Yeah. And how did you get involved with those? Were you interested in hockey as a kid, or was it something, just an opportunity came up?
Yeah, it was a very kismet kind of situation. Like, I just wanted to be an actor, and I auditioned for the sequel after having interviewed some kids from the first movie, because I was like a movie critic for this like local news station in Atlanta. That was the first movie I ever critiqued. And, you know, I just happened to be able to audition for the second one and land it like a year later, which is crazy. If it wasn't for the Mighty Ducks, I wouldn't know how to skate. Like, I couldn't even roller skate, you know? And thank God they had a bit of a maniac hockey coach. He used to coach like the USA, like, kids hockey team. And he was no joke, you know? And for 8 weeks in front of both movies, like, we went to like boot camp with that guy, and he whipped us into shapes, to the point where I can still skate impressively for everybody that doesn't know that I can skate. As soon as I get out there, like, they're like, oh, snap. It's like, that's right, recognize.
And then last, just real quick, if you can just kind of pitch it to people why they should be watching these awards and tuning in Tuesday night.
You gotta watch the NHL Awards. Number one, to pat everybody on the back for a great season and for being such a wonderful community. But number two, it's gonna be some jokes, and I think you're gonna wanna hear them. So tune in. We're going to have fun.
Awesome. Well, you heard it here first, folks, from Kenan himself. Tune in Tuesday night to the NHL Awards at 7:00 on ESPN.
Yeah.